Welcome to the Plant Trainers Podcast, where we're helping people improve their quality of life through nutrition and fitness. And now, your hosts, nutrition and wellness coaches, international speakers, Adam and Shoshana Chaim.
Hey, I'm Adam Chaim.
And I'm Shoshana Chaim, and we are
Propelled by Plants. Today we bring to you episode 314, Life Unrehearsed, CJAD with Plant Trainers. So everyone, welcome to the summer episodes of the Plant Trainers podcast. And as you know, we're super dedicated to putting out at least 52 episodes a year. And also, as you know, like anyone else, a break is needed for rejuvenation, inspiration, as well as the need for a little bit of fun and adventure. If you're a longtime listener, you know that we have creative ways to keep you informed, inspired, and in the know over the summer while we take a short break. So over the next couple of weeks, we'll be sharing with you some of the audios that we grabbed from some of the videos that we created throughout the year. Don't worry, we'll be back at the end of August with our regular 45-minute shows that include high-profile doctors, fitness experts, transformational stories, healthy lifestyle advocates, and juicy podcasts just with us. So while this episode is going to be a little bit shorter, it leaves you with a few minutes to just head to Apple Podcasts and leave us a 5-star rating and review about your favorite show, which hopefully is us. And we do really totally appreciate that. And of course, like always, feel free to share this episode out on all of your social media outlets, because the more people that hear it, the more people will be able to help spread our amazing and important message. Thanks and enjoy the show. We were first introduced to Four Sigmatic Foods while I was browsing a natural food store looking for a coffee-like substance that would provide some energy and some health benefits. And as I was looking around, I was drawn to this mushroom coffee mix. It contained cordyceps and chaga mushrooms, and at the time I was already using cordyceps in my daily routine, and just mixing it with a coffee, it seemed like a perfect match. This combination really got me going in the morning, whether I was getting ready for a short run or a long run, it didn't matter. The best part is that when you use this mix, you don't even need a coffee machine. And so no matter where you train, you just need a mug and some hot water and a packet and you're good to go. The quality is amazing. The chaga mushrooms help support daily immune functions, and the cordyceps have incredible antioxidant properties. They provide energy, stamina, and help to improve athletic performance. They use 100% organically grown Arabica beans in every packet, and it's all third-party tested. And now, best of all, they have these pods. So if you do have a Keurig, you now can have this mushroom mix coffee in your Keurig, which is pretty awesome. So if you want to get a head start on your training day, go to foursigmatic.com/planttrainers. That's foursigmatic.com/planttrainers. Search for the item that calls to you the most and be sure to put in the discount code PLANTTRAINERS, all one word lowercase, to get 15% off your order at checkout. And now for a moment of gratitude. So at this point in the show, we normally give you our moment of gratitude and encourage you to do the same. But since we've recorded these in advance, our moment of gratitude wouldn't be as timely. And so what we'd love for you to do is just take a moment to yourself and think about what you're grateful for right now in this very moment, and maybe share it with somebody that you love, because the more we share our gratitude, the more we have to be grateful for.
What do we have coming up on the second?
Coming up, learn how plant-based living has completely overhauled this couple's lifestyle, which in turn literally saved their lives.
And welcome back to Life Unrehearsed. Little Black Eyed Peas, Corrie, and you'll see why we chose Black Eyed Peas for our upcoming guest. I'm Matt Del Vecchio, specializing in free retirement home search and senior transition support.
And I'm Corrie Sirota, clinical social worker and psychotherapist specializing in grief and loss.
Corrie, I'm so excited about this upcoming
segment.
No,
you are. You're hilarious.
It is, you know, because I think it's very polarizing subject. You know, we just had the new Canada Food Guide come out, didn't we? And they really made some, I think, accepted recommendations on how they're doing things. So if you're a beef farmer or a pork farmer, you're probably not too happy, or even a dairy farmer.
Right, yeah.
But it's very, very timely. So why don't you lead us into this?
So yes, I would absolutely agree. I like to say I'm personally on a seafood diet. Every time I see food, I eat it, right?
I knew that was
okay,
coming.
You knew that was coming. But the truth is, I am so excited to chat with our next guest, because most of us kind of say it's about time, I need to do something, I want to take care of it. And what we're seeing is that Canadians are taking it to the next level, but really our guests have really taken it to the next level, and for very good reason. So on the line today, we have Adam Chaim. He's the co-host of a well-ranked plant trainers podcast, a plant-based athlete and nutrition and fitness coach with over 20 years experience. Unfortunately, or fortunately, and we'll hear about it, after a major wake-up call, he adopted a plant-based lifestyle, and now he thrives in all aspects of his life. He's so impressive. Adam is a two-time Ironman triathlete. He completed several marathons and ultra runs and swims. Alongside him, his partner, both personally and professionally, we have on the line Shoshana Shaim. She's the co-host of the Plant Trainers podcast. She's also a Canadian wellness expert. She's working one-on-one with busy individuals to alleviate the stress in their lives caused by diet, lifestyle, and chronic illness. She's an author, international speaker, and a family gal. Welcome to the show, guys.
Thank you so much, Corrie and Matt.
Thank you for having us.
We're going to start right away, because I keep alluding to it, right away with the question about why you guys got into this. How did you get into a journey about plant-based living and this lifestyle?
Yeah, so thanks for this opportunity to share. And around 2009 is when it all started for me. But before that, I was always living an active lifestyle growing up. I became a phys ed teacher, a personal trainer. And health and nutrition was always very important to me, and I thought I was doing the right thing, eating the right way, following Canada's food guide to, you know, the regular North American diet. And in 2009, it's funny we're recording this, we're live on Super Bowl Sunday, but I was sitting on my couch in 2009 watching a football game, and I had this pain run across my chest, which I had to go get checked, and it turned out that I had a tumor on my kidney. And that led to some further research and testing, which showed me that I had the beginning stages of heart disease. And I was pretty young. I was about 37 at the time. And Shoshana was pregnant with our second child. And not long before that, I had a good family friend of mine who passed away at such an early age, who left his wife and kids behind. And so when I was told that I had a tumor and I had the beginning stages of heart disease at the age of 37, I figured I had to do something. And other than removing body parts unnecessarily, which is what the surgeons and doctors wanted to do, they wanted to take out my kidney immediately, I needed to find something else that I could do as a solution. And I found a lot of research and evidence of a plant-based diet and how it helps prevent and reverse certain illnesses and diseases. And heart disease was one of those. And so that's what led me to the path and got me to where I am today. And the bio that you just read sounded pretty awesome. And I just want to say that I'm really an average person, but because of what I've done with my life, I think that I've turned into an above-average person, and everybody out there could do the same for themselves.
You're listening to Life Unrehearsed. That's Adam and Shoshana Chaim talking about plant-based living. And Adam, if I understand correctly, you were given 5 years to live, and that was how many years ago?
Yeah, they told me that I'd be dead by the age of 40, and now I'm 44, and I'm in the best shape of my life. I feel fantastic, and I'm thriving with everything I do.
Way to go. Now, you're talking to a meat and potatoes guy here, Adam and Shoshana, and when I recently read parts and saw summaries of the Canada's Food Guide, which you mentioned also, you were following the Canada's Food Guide, things have changed quite drastically. You have been doing this for a long time. It seems like maybe some of the government people were listening to you, but obviously, concentrating more on plant-based foods, validating everything you're doing. I think plant-based food group was an alternative food group before, and now it's not. And I think dairy is no longer a food group. So how does this all tie into plant trainers and what you're doing? And how are you going to convince a meat and potatoes guy like me to maybe consider an alternative lifestyle?
If you listen to this podcast, we know that you like what we have to offer. But did you know that we're putting out content every single day and we're having amazing conversations with people just like you in our Facebook group, Plant-Based Health, Nutrition, and Fitness? The group is for people like you looking to improve their life through plant-based nutrition and fitness and who are passionate about a compassionate lifestyle. But we have really big announcements coming up. So if you're a health coach, a personal trainer, or someone who feels that they could heal the world with their skills, talents, and messages, be sure to jump into Plant-Based Health, Nutrition, and Fitness. We can't wait to see you there.
And now, back to the show.
Well, Matt, first I want to say that you should probably give peas a chance. You know, we're really happy with what's happened with the food guide. Of course, there's a lot of people out there who aren't, like a lot of animal farmers, and even some people who are plant-based feel that Canada hasn't taken enough steps. But we really feel that there's a big push for plant-based alternatives. They've even said choose plant-based proteins more often. There's no more juices. There's no more push for milk. I think that they've realized the connection that food has in our body and that, you know, processed meat has been a class one carcinogen by the World Health Organization, and there's a lot of correlation between certain breast cancers and colon rectal cancer and meat. So I think that as we start to take these steps, we're going to see cholesterol is going to come down. Hopefully certain rates of cancer will come down. Obesity might not be as such an epidemic. We're going to see some really great changes, just like we've seen ourselves here in our home. After 1 year of eating plant-based, we saw that Adam's tumor had begun to shrunk and that his heart disease had cleared up and he didn't have all of that guck filling up his arteries anymore. And it's just the doctors didn't understand how that was possible. They wanted to know who else he went to, but at the end of the day, this is the effect it's had on our family. We've had amazing results with so many of our clients. If people want to be at their very best, this is a step in the right direction.
Absolutely true, but I want to go back to what I understand is you had a hesitation. True or not? True or false?
Absolutely.
So what was your hesitation in starting it? Because I'm now, or Matt's now, or a lot of us are now hesitating, and we need to know how did you go to the dark side?
Well, to circle back around, first of all, I was a teacher before this, and Adam is a teacher as well. So we're used to teaching, the health curriculum, which ties back into the Canada's Food Guide. And actually, as one of my practicums, I had done a practicum at the Mackay Center, believe it or not, which is quite incredible. But, we were used to teaching. We were taught and we were teaching the food groups, to eat meat, to drink milk. These are the things that we were taught and we lived with. So when Adam came home and said, I want to be plant-based, and I said, what does that mean? And he said, vegan. And I said, is that some kind of vegetarian? I didn't even know what he was talking about. I didn't know if that was going to hurt us, if we were going to be malnourished, if it was going to keep our children from developing the way that they should. So I was scared because it was something out of the norm, and it wasn't something that other people were doing, and I didn't know how to do it and make sure that we were as healthy as possible.
So Shoshana and Adam, it's 4:45. We're going to cut out for a traffic update. But, okay, you're slowly convincing me, okay? And Corrie, I see she's got a little smile on her face here as well. I guess what we want to hear, and I think a lot of people want to hear, what would be the first step to beginning to live a plant-based lifestyle?
Welcome back. You're listening to Life Unrehearsed. I'm Corrie Sirota with my co-host, Matt Del Vecchio, and we are talking with plant trainers Adam and Shoshana Shame. They are talking to us about plant-based living and giving us a ton of really important information. So I'm just going to go right into it. Again, it can be very daunting to try and do this, even if you know it's good for you. So how would the novice person start off?
Yeah, so Corrie, Matt, anything that's new to people can be a big challenge and difficult. And the truth is that it's become easier now than ever, especially with Canada's Food Guide recommending that we eat more plants. So let's keep it really simple. Let's first off add more plants wherever we can. So whenever you could eat a bit more veggie, go for it, whether it's in soups, stews, or salads. You know, add in more of the good foods and slowly the bad foods will get crowded out. Think about eating less processed foods and eat more real whole foods. It's really that simple. And to make it even easier for people, don't do it all at once like I did. Just take it one step at a time. Maybe even start with one meal a day. Maybe even one meal a week if you have to. It depends on the level of your commitment that you want to make to your health. Because at the end of the day, what you need to remember is that what you put in your mouth is going to do one of two things. It's going to help heal you or it's going to harm you. So you got to think of what's important here.
That's Adam. Oh, sorry, Shoshana, go ahead.
I was going to say, if you want a little bit more practical, then what you can do is you could start to use maybe lentils instead of ground beef when you're making a chili. Or you can decide all your breakfasts are going to be plant-based and just get your head around one meal. So do oatmeal and smoothie bowls and all kinds of things like that. There's tons and tons of recipes out if you just Google plant-based or even, you know, get yourself a plant-based cookbook. There's so much help that you can get.
That's Shoshana and Adam Cheam. Adam, leave it to your wife to talk practical, right? I mean, it's. But I tell you what, it's. I've been on your site, Plant Trainers, and it is incredible. You have podcasts. I was so impressed. You have show notes on your podcast, what you discuss, and on your site you have recipes. So being Super Bowl Sunday, by the way, we're going to a Super Bowl party, my daughter and I, afterwards, and I saw the menu, Corrie. We've got all meat pizza. We've got beef sliders and chicken wings on the menu.
So I know that Adam, I just recently saw, because I subscribe to your website. Give us a sneak peek of Super Bowl foods, plant-based.
Well, if you checked out our Instagram this week, you would have seen we posted cauliflower nuggets. So we've actually breaded cauliflower nuggets, and you could use any kind of dipping sauce that you want. We're going to have nachos with salsa, refried beans, black beans, guacamole, all of those great trimmings. You can make a flatbread pizza, or you can order pizza in. You could just leave out the cheese, but a lot of places will have dairy-free cheese these days, and then a banana and ice cream for dessert with a little bit of a chocolate chip bar to spice it up a little bit.
Works for me.
Well, you know, it's very exciting because there is now competition's increasing. People are getting more and more creative with their recipes. It's starting to taste better, so there's this huge momentum. But a little more serious note, Shoshana, I believe it was your son that had eczema, and who would have thought plant-based living would have helped your son in this case?
Yeah, so what we need to recognize is that foods play havoc on our system, and if it's foods that our system don't want, or if it's foods that we're not supposed to have as much of and our bodies aren't used to it, not everybody's able to handle it, everybody's able to process it. We did take gluten out of his diet because he was allergic to gluten, and that helped, but it didn't clear it up enough. He was scratching through the night. He would wake up irritable in the morning because he hadn't slept well, and he was even bleeding around his eyes. And when we took out dairy and eggs, it was extremely, extremely clear how inflammatory that had been for him, how much his system could not deal with it, and how well he can thrive without that.
Oh, thank God that you discovered and you acted upon it. So that's an incredible, if that's not a reason to look into the plant-based lifestyle, I don't know what is. The other thing, and I feel like this is funny because I'm such a positive person and I just sound like I'm the naysayer today, but I'm thinking about cost. I'm sure you hear, well, it's going to cost me more. Can you debunk that myth as well?
Absolutely. So I want to support that in a minute, just to say that if you're going to buy a frozen pizza, it's probably going to cost $2.50 in the store. But if you're going to buy one that's you know, vegan and it's vegan cheese and it's gluten-free, you're probably going to pay $10. So when you're looking at prepaid frozen food compared to junk food that might be subsidized by the government because of the dairy and what have you, then there will be a big price difference. But when you look at real food, so if we put this in perspective, a beefsteak can cost somewhere between 20 to 30 pounds sometimes just for a piece of steak, but black beans are going to cost you less than $5 for a pound, and that's going to be dried. So once you cook those, you're going to be able to eat for a week off of $5 and add it with other grains that are really in cost effective as well. One bag of potatoes is $2.99, which can make, you know, two meals for a family, but if you're going to buy frozen french fries, 2.2 pounds as opposed to 10 pounds is going to be even more at 3:30. So it's really about choosing the right kinds of foods, and you could definitely cut down your grocery bill from what it is now.
Well, there's no question that we can have this conversation, and we have just touched the tip of the iceberg because it's an ongoing, very important one. Please let, I want to thank you, and please let our listeners know, how do people get a hold of you guys and more information?
Well, thanks so much for having us. If people want to check us out, they can go to planttrainers.com. They could send us an email at info@planttrainers.com. Like you mentioned before, Matt, we have the Plant Trainers podcast, which people are welcome to listen to. It's on all kinds of platforms, including iHeartRadio, and our social media handle, Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter, we're at Plant Trainers. We love to interact with people, so we hope you can catch us at any of those places.
Adam and Shoshana, thank you so much for enlightening us. Really appreciate it.
Thank you all so much for listening to this edition of the Plant Trainers podcast. We want to make sure that you subscribe on iTunes, Google Play, iHeartRadio, Stitcher, or any other podcasting platform.
We really appreciate the feedback we receive from you. Every time we get a 5-star rating or review on iTunes from one of our fans, it really helps other people find us, just like you did.
Thanks so much to our patrons. To become a patron, visit us at patreon.com/planttrainers. Even supporting us with $1 really makes a difference in the quality of the show.
And don't forget to connect with us on Instagram and Twitter. Our handle is @planttrainers. Like Plant Trainers on Facebook, join our newsletter, and check out our website at planttrainers.com for awesome recipes, a list of our services, and of course, our latest podcast.
We encourage you to email your questions to info@planttrainers.com so that we can help you improve your quality of life through nutrition and fitness.
So we hope we've inspired you today. Join us again next time, and have a healthy day. Or is that too corny?
It's a little cheesy.